True, he told me age is just a number. In April when I was 14, this guy messaged me on Facebook while I was in the middle of second hour and acted like he thought I was someone else, then told me to text him. After I texted him, we were talking for hours and hours. For the sake of not repeating him all the time, I'm going to call him Dave. I looked at Dave's profile to make sure he was real and not a creepy guy. His profile said he went to my school, past tense went, but it is common to see past tense on a lot of profiles of people who actually attend my school, since there is an age limit when making a profile. When I arrived home, I finally asked him how old he was. He told me he was 19. My heart sank to the pit of my stomach. I thought that maybe he had been my age, around 15 or at least 16. I ignored the 6-year age gap and continued to talk to him, because I felt we had a real connection. My parents were out of town, and my grandma was staying at my house to watch me. Dave asked if he could meet me, and I agreed. It was still daylight, and I offered to meet him at a nearby park in 15 minutes, since I would not be allowed out any time past 7, because it would be dark. Dave said he would not be able to make it, but he was determined to meet me. So after a while I finally agreed to let him over to my house after my grandma went to bed. Right after grandma went to bed, I ran downstairs and set up a bunch of blankets in the backyard. The entire time waiting for him, my stomach was twisting, and I had a really bad feeling, but dismissed it as just being anxious since I have a bad anxiety problem. Dave texted me and told me he had arrived. I went to the side gate and saw him. We hugged, and I still had a really bad feeling. Dave arrived at my house at 11 p.m., and he did not leave until almost 5 a.m. While he was there, he said he was really into me and did not think age should be a factor in romance. I agreed because, though he may be creepy and sketchy, he was so hot. We kissed. He asked me to be his girlfriend. I said yes. Then it got sexual. He kept grabbing me very forcefully and it made me uncomfortable, but I went along with it thinking whatever, it's nothing, it's not a big deal. But even though I may have been stupid, I was smart enough to not let him actually try to have sex with me, but I still wanted to mess around. We came up with a safe word, a word used when things need to stop because you are uncomfortable, dolphin, because we both had a fascination with dolphins and whales. Later in the night we were talking about drugs and alcohol. I was talking badly about drug addiction. And then Dave told me he was addicted to DXM, which is an ingredient in cough syrup. Dave went home, and then the next night he came back over. This time, he had wine and weed. Alright, whatever, people around my age like to smoke weed and get drunk, nothing to worry about. We drank out of the bottle and smoked a little bit. He was getting tipsy, and luckily I have a high tolerance for both weed and alcohol. He kept telling me I needed to drink more. Come on, you have to drink more, it's fine, just drink a little more. Even after I kept telling him no, he kept pushing on, and finally I was convinced he was trying to get me faded so he could take advantage of me. I had enough of this and told him to leave. That was the last time I saw him. But we kept talking. We exchanged I love yous, and we would always talk dirty, but he would always say something sketchy like, when I see you again, you better not use our safe word. That freaked me out so much. Towards the end of the relationship, we got in a lot of fights. Dave would always guilt trip me into staying by saying, I stopped using DXM for you, and in more serious arguments, he would always call me a whore and say I was ugly. A lot more minor details to the story, but finally I just cut him off completely and have not talked to him in years. My gut really tells me if I had stayed, something really bad might have happened. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button to support my work. And as always, enjoy the fear, my dear.